What's good, YouTube? Welcome back to The Brown Gent. If you're new here, this channel is all about creating wealth. If that's something that you want to hear more about, make sure you subscribe so you keep seeing more of my content. I started this channel because a lot of financial advice out there is nonsensical and really just a bunch of people trying to sell courses or farm views by encouraging bad investing practices. If you want to be able to reach out to me or hear what's going on before a video can be posted, here's a link to our free public Discord, Spades Investing. Definitely consider joining it, especially if you want some support on your journey to financial freedom. Now, this has been one of my most requested videos, starting your investment journey. So we're gonna start from ground zero. How exactly do you start investing? Now, I'm not gonna lie to you. It can definitely be disheartening and overwhelming when you wanna start out. People who started investing before you already have sizable accounts, and this always scales up. You may be envious of a friend who has $1,000 in investments, but they're envious of someone who has 10K, and they're envious of someone who has 100K, and hopefully you see where I'm going with this. It's just like day one of stepping into a gym. You've wanted to take care of your health for a long time, but let's be honest, you're there to put on some muscle while trimming fat to show off a nice six pack. Maybe you're there to impress the ladies, but let's say you hop onto the bench press and you just bench 95 pounds. You wipe off the bench because you're not a piece of shit and you're proud of yourself. And you should be, you just hit a new PR. But then the guy who uses the bench press right after you uses that weight to warm up before going up to 3 plates. All of a sudden, your great accomplishment, it feels like nothing. But here's the thing, that person didn't just walk into the gym and get to 3 plates on day one. So give yourself a break and give yourself time to get there. The only person you should ever be comparing yourself to is yourself from a day ago. Just take a look at my YouTube channel. It's a little over 750 subscribers right now, but that's nothing if I was to compare myself to other channels. However, I think my content and my style is getting better with each video, and the growth this channel has seen is reflective of that. That's all that's important to me. Well, that and you subscribing, so make sure you hit that button right now to add to that count. So what is investing like? People always say when you're investing, invest what you're willing to lose. Now, I think this is really taken the wrong way. You're definitely not gambling, but you should be viewing your money as an army of soldiers that will make you more money. Sometimes some of your army dies off for the better cause, sometimes your army expands, and sometimes your army is stuck somewhere for 4 months. So it's not so much what you're willing to lose, but what you're willing to be without for a while. So what is investing not like? Investing is not gambling. I know that with gamified applications, a lot of people treat investing in stocks and cryptos like it's gambling. Yeah, you can gamble, but this is actually a surefire way to lose money in the long term. If you want to make consistent money at a casino, you play poker. You don't play blackjack or roulette. And when you invest haphazardly and always chasing the next hype or your losses, you end up losing a lot of money. You may not make as much when you invest intelligently, but it's way more safe and it's way more consistent. I always hear diamond hands and just average down, but you wouldn't put your diamond hands in shit, right? And averaging down is only a concept that works with investments that actually have long-term inherent value, not pump and dumps.
Pump always, guys, respect the pump.
So then how do you start? How much money can you comfortably put aside to invest? This is the first question you need to ask yourself. Even if you're broke right now when you're watching this, can you save $10 a month to start investing? And if you're watching this video and your financial situation is better than that, maybe it's $50 a month, or even $100, or $1,000. Find out what number works best for you. The beauty about investing is you can start with any amount. Don't feel disheartened if you don't have that much money to start with. And if you want to invest in stocks, sign up with a brokerage. If you live in Canada, Questrade is the best brokerage with the smallest fees for a beginner. And if you want a sign-up bonus, I have an affiliate link in the description below, and it also supports the channel. Now, if you want to invest in crypto, AscendEx is the one I would suggest. They have the lowest fees and the highest selection of coins. My link below gets you 10% off your fees for the first year, but I don't think they're available to US citizens right now. So I do have a bonus link to Coinbase for my US homies in the description below. Keep depositing your extra money into your investment account and don't just spend it because it's there. It's not burning a hole in your pocket, so let it accumulate as cash. We call that buying power. So then the next question I get asked is, what do you invest in? Well, when you first start investing, lots of people fluctuate to what stocks or asset classes have the most noise around them. This ends up with newbies having portfolios full of speculative investments. Instead, you should look to start off your investment portfolio by buying more stable investments and only look to expand once you've gotten more comfortable. Such investments are index funds such as VOO and QQQ. These are the safest investments as they track the major indices and evaluate the performance of all the companies in that said index. And because of this, over the long term, they have shown to provide a 6 to 8% return per year. Now, that's not a big return by any means, but that's one that you can more or less rely on. Other good investments are solid companies like Facebook, Apple, and Amazon. These provide a better return on average than the typical index fund, but they also come with more inherent risk, since they rely on the performance of just one company. You could look to also invest in dividend companies, which pay you every so often as a shareholder, or you could just invest in value-oriented companies whose share price will increase much more over time, like Tesla. If you're investing into crypto, the safest ones are Bitcoin and Ethereum. Cardano and Ripple are also very good investments, but they're nowhere near as proven as the first two. No matter what you buy, it's important that you understand why you're purchasing it. This is what I refer to as doing your own due diligence. Don't just buy something because someone else is confident in it. You need to be as well. And I try to keep about 20 to 30% of my non-invested portfolio as cash, so that I can take advantage of dips in the future versus being all in. So now you know what you want to buy, how do you start buying? So that's what we call starting a position. And that just means you started an investment. Depending on where you live, you may have access to no transaction fee brokerages. If so, I'm super jealous of you. If not, you want to make sure that your transaction fees don't make up more than 2% of your purchase. Let's say I pay $5 per transaction. It makes no sense for me to buy $100 worth of shares because then I'm paying 5% of the value when I buy and another 5% when I sell. In this situation, I would have to buy about $500 worth of shares since $10 is 2% of 500. Something else you can consider is not buying all of your shares in a company at once. Let's say I wanted to buy 200 shares of Ocugen at $9. Maybe I'd buy my first 50 shares at $9, and then if it dropped to $7.50, I'd buy another 75, and then my last 75 at $5 a piece. This gives me a much lower average price, aka cost basis, and I win either way. If I bought the shares at $9 and they never went lower, then I just make money. I make less money than I would have had I bought all 200 shares, but who cares? There will always be another great play in the market, but for some reason, it never feels like you have enough money to play them all. Now, the toughest part about being an investor is holding on to your investments when they keep going down during a market correction or a calamity. This is why before you buy anything, it's so important that you understand why you're invested. And if you want to hear about the 5 biggest mistakes I made when I first started investing, as well as how I overcame them, I'll put that on the end screen. In this, I also refer to selling your investment too early and taking profits, which can make you really sad when it keeps going up after. And it's always important to have a plan when you invest, and in this case, you should also identify what your exit strategy is. There are only 4 stocks in my portfolio that I don't plan on selling, unless they see some ridiculous 2x movement in a day. And in those cases, I will only sell to buy back in when it corrects. Bonus if you can comment below on what those 4 stocks are. The majority of your investments will either be short-term or long-term swing trades, and you should have a clear plan so that you aren't flying by the seat of your pants. And with that, I'll wrap it up for this video. I tried to keep it as simple as I could. I hope that this video helps as you start on your investing journey. And if you want me to make another video conveying investment strategy, or if you have a topic that you'd like me to cover, let me know in the comments below. And if you got some value out of this video, make sure that you share it with your friends who are considering getting into investing. And while you're at it, like and subscribe and join our growing family. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching.